aim of this lesson is to make you understand the various stages of processing and analysis of data. On the completion of this lesson, you should be able to process, tabulate, and analyze data. Data processing. Once data are collected, researchers turn their focus of attention on its processing and analysis. In this lesson, we will discuss about one of the most important stages of the research process, that is data processing and analysis. First of all, researchers have to make their plan of processing and analysis of data. To some researchers, data processing and analysis is not a very serious activity. They feel many a time that data processing is a job of computer assistants. As a consequence, they have to be contented with the results given by the computer assistants, which may not help them to achieve their objectives. To avoid such situation, it is essential that data processing must be planned in advance. Data processing refers to certain operations such as editing, coding, computing of the scores, preparation of master charts, etc. After collection of filled-in questionnaires, editing of entries therein are not only necessary but also useful in making subsequent steps simpler. Many a times, a researcher either misses entry in the questionnaires or enter responses which are not legible. This sort of discrepancies can be resolved by editing the schedule meticulously. Another problem comes at the time of tabulation of data, when researcher asks for tabulation of responses from consecutive questions. In cases where data are not edited, there has to be inconsistency in the tabulations. The researcher has to be very particular about consecutive questions where category not applicable exists. Coding of data. Coding of data involves assigning of numbers to each response of the question. The purpose of giving numbers is to translate categorical data into numeric data, which may be counted and tabulated. The task of researcher is to give numbers to response carefully. For example, a closed-end question may be already coded and hence it has to be just included in the code book, whereas coding of open-end questions involves operations such as classification of major responses and developing a response category of others for responses which were not given frequently. The classification of response is primarily based on similarities or differences among the responses. Usually, in the case of open-end questions, to classify responses, researcher looks for major characteristics of the responses and puts it accordingly. In case of attitude scales, researcher has to keep in mind the direction or weightage of responses. For example, a response strongly agree is coded as 5. The subsequent codes would be in order. Therefore, if there are responses like agree, undecided, disagree, and strongly disagree, they have to be coded as 4, 3, 2, and 1. Alternatively, if strongly agree is coded as -2, the subsequent responses would be coded as -1, 0, +1, and +2. The matrix questions have to be coded taking into consideration each cells as one variable. For example, if the column of matrix represents employment status, namely permanent and temporary, and the row represents employers of type of employer, namely government and private, The first cell would represent a variable, government permanent. The second cell will represent government temporary, and so on. In order to demonstrate the point discussed above, a section of a code book is presented here. In a code book, there are 5 columns. First column represents question number. Second column gives variable numbers. Third is information short. Fourth, responses. And fifth column gives the codes. In first column, we write the question number, which is likely to be analyzed. So you can see the code book. It starts with 2. It may be because question number 1, the data need not be analyzed. It could be the name of the respondent or village, circle, etc. These are only identification information. We don't need to analyze. So it does not appear in the code book. Variable number is information for further processing. Since we do not have consecutive question numbers, variable number we have to give from the beginning to the end in consecutive orders. So you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, and it goes on. In a question, there may be sub-question. The sub-questions may have 2 variable numbers. That also you have to note. Third column, we give information short. That is, by asking a question, what kind of information you are asking? So in very brief, we convey the information short. So for factual data, you can see age, designation, establishment. But when it comes to the statement, you can just give in brief few words. Next column, we give responses, which are expected from the respondents. Here we have to remember, the responses which are in numeric values, we need not give codes, because it can be directly tabulated. For example, variable 1 is age, and response is likely to be in numerics. It may be 32 years. So we say here, you can see the code column, the last column, we have put dash. That means we have to transfer the numeric value to the master chart. We do not give the codes. Next is designation. It is a categorical variable where we are expecting 3 responses: worker, supervisor, manager. Now it can be coded as 1, 2, 3. Establishment is also a categorical variable. Level of education is a categorical but ordinal variable where you have to maintain the order. The code should be given according to either ascending order or descending order. Here it is in descending order. Graduate, intermediate, high school, middle school, primary, illiterate. You have a choice. You can have ascending order where you can start with illiterate, primary, middle, high school, like that. We include a category called others, because sometimes we may get a response like homeopathic doctor or DHMS, some other degrees which we cannot go on listing, diploma, certificate course. So we all those categories we put in others. So wherever we feel some response which may not fit into the pre-coded, we put a category called others. Then matter status, we have fixed category, but here also we have number of other categories. These are usually married, unmarried, widow and divorce. We can have also widower and divorcees. So here you can explain one category, divorcee and divorce, widow and widower. Or if you want separate analysis, you can do separately. But there are responses today, deserted or living together, could be a new answers. So that you have to make the provisions. Now comes monthly salary. Here we also use actuals. And then we just transfer the data to the master chart as given by the respondents. Caste, religion also needs a kind classification called others, because there may be a caste which may not fit into this, or they would like to be separated. Variable 8, information sought is about caste. Many times a response may not fit into pre-categorized responses. For this purpose, we keep a category called others. In same way, for religion also, we have to keep others, because there are a number of religions which are in minority, like Parsis, Sikh, Buddhist. So we need not give all the responses codes, but all those minority religions we can put in one category. There's a special note about actuals, numeric variables. For numeric variables like age, it is a must. You must get the data. But in case, number of children, for example, this is a conjugative question which we have discussed earlier, or what we call contingency questions. Now, this has a relation with the marital status. That means this question applies to only married respondent in variable 5. We have married, unmarried, widow, divorce. For question number 14, variable number 15, we have to add one category called not applicable. That means respondents who are unmarried will be put under not applicable category. The others may have number of children, 1, 2, as responded by the respondent. Same is also applicable to monthly income. If a respondent is housewife, she may say that, I don't have any monthly income. Here we can write not applicable. And we give a code. The convention is for not applicable, 1-digit response we give 9. 2-digit, 99. More than 2, you can go on using 999. Master chart. After the code book is prepared, the data are transferred to a master chart. A sample of master chart prepared in accordance with the code book discussed above is presented here. A master chart is a summary of data. When we have got filled in questionnaires and prepared our code book, now with the help of code book, we can transfer the data from questionnaire to master chart. And the format of master chart is, first of all, we give variable labels. And you can see here we have age, designation, establishment, level of education, marital status, nature of work, duration of work, wages, promotions, etc. The first column represents respondent number. Second column is age. Now, for our tabulation purpose, we give numbers to variable and we call it variable number. So you can see B1, B2, B4, B5, B6, B7. It helps us in counting and representing as the tables. Now, if you go through one row, which represents respondent number 1, The responses of the respondents are in numeric form. You can see the second column, 24. That means respondent 1 is of 24 years of age. Designation 1. Now in the code book, we have given 1. We have designation as manager, supervisor, workers. So 1 represents worker. When we come to the next column, establishment, it says 2. We have given codes to establishment, public sector 1, private sector 2. Respondent has said 2. That means he works in private sector. Level of education is 1. Is a graduation, first category. Marital status is 2, means unmarried. Likewise, we can just see the data, the responses converted into numeric value. If we go by column wise, it gives the all values of the variable for the respondents. So see that column 2, we have 24, 21, 23, 25, like that. The purpose of preparing master chart is now counting and tabulating the data. We can count how many ones, for example, designation. We can count how many 1, how many 2s, how many 3s. That will tell us how many respondents are workers, how many respondents are supervisors, how many respondents are managers. Similarly, for establishment, we can count 1s and 2s and find out the summary that how many respondents are in public sectors and how many were working in private sectors. Further processing, we will learn through TallySheet, tabulation of data. The data collected for the purpose of research study are simple figures without any form or structure. Data entered in master chart are in raw state, for they have not gone through any statistical treatment. This shapeless mass of data is known as raw data. TallySheet. The raw data is grouped by making a TallySheet, wherein repetitions of particular data is marked by tallies. A TallySheet is shown here. For further processing of data, we prepare a TallySheet. Here is a part of a TallySheet, about 20 respondents, 1 variable each, to explain you how we make TallySheet from the master chart for each variable we have to make. In the TallySheet, you can see first column gives you the age. After going through the data in the master chart, we take the minimum value and maximum value, and in column 1, we start with the minimum value and we give the consecutive numerics, consecutive numbers. You can see here 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and it goes up to maximum. Now, in column 2, you can see tallies. Now, we go through the master chart, the first column, age, the variable age, and what numbers appear there, we mark a tally here. Referring to the master chart, we find that respondent number 1 is 24 years of age. So we mark 1 tally in tally column. The second respondent is 23. So we mark another tally in row 23. And in 24, we mark another tally. We go on looking at the number values in the master chart and mark as a tally. By convention, once 4 tallies are there, 5th tallies we put in diagonal, and it's just for counting 5. After all the variables, we have to prepare the master chart. Now we have to make the totals. In the last column, you can see in TallySheet, it gives you the total tallies. And it shows that one respondent is 20 years, 3 respondents are 21 years, 6 respondents are 22 years, and so on and so forth. Total number of tallies is indicated by F, that is frequencies. One-way table, in order that data may be more rapidly communicable, data are grouped further, which reduces the bulk of data. The group data is presented in the form of one-way table. One-way table refers to tables which present data relating to one variable. One-way table, which are more commonly known as frequency distribution table, so how frequently an item repeats. Example of one-way table is presented here. Now, we can prepare our table. We will just see how we prepare one-way table. The format you can see, this is by convention we follow in social science research. The first column we just give serial number. Second column we give the variable name. Third column we say frequency. And fourth column we say percentage. Now to comprehend the data rapidly, now we further group the tally sheet frequencies. The grouping can be by a statistical measure like median or quartiles. And you can see here we have grouped it like 20 years to 22 years, 22 years to 24 years, 24 years to 26 years, 26 years to 28 years, 28 years to 30 years. After making this group, now we refer to the tally sheets and we count how many respondents are in 2022. Obviously, we can see here 3 and 1, that is 4. Second group, 22 to 24, 9. 24, 26, 4. 28, 30, 3. Total 20. Then we calculate the percentage, taking 20 as a base. So out of 20, 4 is in 20 to 22 years of age group, that is 20%. 9 out of 20, 45%. 4 out of 20, 20%. 3 out of 20, 15%. Total will be 100%. Summary. One of the important stages of the research process is processing and analysis of data. Data processing refers to certain operations such as editing, coding, computing of scores, and preparation of master chart. The raw data is grouped by making a tally sheet, wherein repetitions of the particular data is marked by tallies. In order to comprehend data rapidly, data are grouped further, which reduces the bulk of data. The group data is presented in the form of one-way table.